In 1945, millions of GIs returned home to a life drastically unfamiliar. Searching for action, GIs began buying motorcycles. Motorcycle clubs started appearing. Some clubs were for fun and a means of camaraderie, but for others, that wasn't enough. At the end of the 1940s, outlaw motorcycle clubs had begun. Since that time, clubs like the Hells Angels, Banditos, Mongols, and Pagans have changed the perception that Americans have about bikers. But they are not the only bikers trying to change communities.
Been riding motorcycles probably over 30 years.
About 12 years.
About 20 years.
I just loved the motor that was underneath my seat, I guess you could say, and just the thrill of getting out there riding and the wind in my face.
I just enjoyed riding, having the wind in my face.
I like to ride and go fast.
Oh, well, definitely. I used to always see it on TV. You saw the HAs, the Hells Angels and stuff, and that's what everybody always recognized and saw. And so you'd see those and be like, hey, one day, man, I might want to be something like that until you figure out what it's all about.
I've been in bars before where I walk in wearing my colors, and I walk in with my wife, and we just walk in and make ourselves available, and you'll catch somebody's glance. They're looking over at you, and they'll give you a head nod, possibly something like that.
People come in here, they've never seen anything like this, a church where people ride motorcycles and going to church, you know, and coming to church dressed how you are. Blue jeans and a t-shirt.
Yeah, well, I mean, we go to different areas, different motorcycle bars and clubs here in the local area. Just go there and just be a part of the atmosphere there. Just go there and shoot pool with the guys, play foosball, just be a part of the community and fellowship with them, and just go in there and just be that beacon of light that God's called us to be. Well, I've seen definitely, I mean, time and time again, you go in there and, you know, you sit down and somebody will come sit down beside you and say, hey, man, what type of work do you do? You know, who are you? And then that opens up that door for me and everything. Hey, I pastor of a biker church. And that gets their interest and piques their interest. And plus, usually when we go, we're wearing our shirts that say Freedom Biker Church on it as well. And they see that. And so that opens up a door for us to sort of share the gospel to them and what God's doing here and gaining that rapport and that respect from them. And then at that point, you start seeing them actually come through here. I just talked to somebody this morning and said they got a guy from one of the clubs and stuff. He came to the parking lot about four Sundays ago. He rode in, but he didn't stay, but he turned around and left. Well, then the next Sunday he came in, he rode all the way to the front of the building, but he didn't stay. He turned around and went back out. Well, the third Sunday he came, he parked his motorcycle, walked on the inside of the door and just stood there, never came inside the sanctuary. Well, the fourth Sunday, which was today, he not only came in the parking lot, he parked his motorcycle, he walked through that door, and he's sitting to service today. So it's just that seeing how God's working on them, and they just want to come and see mainly, hey, who are you guys? What are you about? Are you who you say you are? Are you a biker church? Or are you just every other church on the corner?